Don't forget you have 5 minutes, but I have these.
Good evening, and thank you for having me. My name is Kirsten Manahan, and tonight I stand here before you all in hopes of becoming Andres Bonifacio Sanjuan's Vice Chairperson for the 2017-2018 school year. Before I tell you why I'm running for this position and why I believe I'd be a good candidate, let me tell you about myself. I'm a second year applied mathematics major from Fullerton, California. I have 3 brothers and 2 loving parents. In my free time, I like to watch movies, explore new places, dance, and sing. I enjoy eating at Italian and Mexican restaurants. I work as a Calculus 2 workshop leader and math tutor for student athletes. I started to get more involved with my Filipino culture when I joined the Filipino club at my high school. After being a general member for a year, I ran for the Filipino American Culture Night coordinator position my junior year and was able to put on a production of my own. Since then, I have been fascinated with the beautiful culture of the Philippines and knew that I wanted to remain involved when I came to college. As most of you know, this year, I had the privilege of being AB Sanjuan's academic coordinator. To be completely honest with you, going into this position, I had no idea what I was supposed to be doing. I had never been to a high school conference or a Filipino graduation. So for the most part, I only had a vision of what these events were supposed to be like in my head, with no real experience to guide me. Nonetheless, I did not let my inexperience hinder me. I put in 110% to make up for what I lacked. I made sure that I did everything I could to be the best possible academic coordinator I could be. And now, with the majority of the school year behind us, I can confidently say that I am proud of what I accomplished. When people would acknowledge me for a job well done, they'd say that things went so smoothly and that I made it look easy. But was it easy? Definitely not. It may have been hard to tell, but last semester, I truly believe that I hit the lowest point in my life thus far. Day by day, I was slowly falling deeper and deeper into a hole that I created for myself. I was working 24/7 and barely got any sleep. And no one knew, but I cried almost every week because of how exhausting it all was. I wanted to give up so badly, but I knew that there were so many people counting on me. But little did I realize that I was giving so many pieces of myself to a number of other things that I forgot to save some for me. I hardly ever took time to sit back and do things that I enjoyed. I couldn't get a relief, and the continuous fatigue was gnawing away at my health, confidence, and self-esteem. What hit me the hardest was my inability to do all these things while staying on top of my studies. Growing up, my parents always took pride in my good grades, bragging to family members, awarding me with material items, things like that. It became so prevalent that I started to see myself as the hardworking, focused, and intelligent daughter they were so proud of. It became part of my self-image. And last semester, when I couldn't fulfill that image, I lost a sense of who I was. I became so used to my grades dictating my self-esteem that I let it break me down. I know it sounds foolish to let something like grades, which becomes so irrelevant in the grand scheme of things, decide how I feel about myself. But you have to understand that this became a norm for me, and I simply couldn't help it. Now, you're probably wondering why I just told you all that, and how it has anything at all to do with the reason I'm standing up here right now. But after hearing my experience being on executive board last year, you may be thinking, why would she ever want to come back? What could she have possibly gained? Well, let me tell you what. Even after all that, I know that everything I went through was a learning experience, and it taught me a lot. I have grown so much since the beginning of the school year, and because of that, I am a better me. And that is what I love so much about this opportunity. Having been able to serve the members of this community and in the end come out, not only an improved leader, but also an improved person, was a unique privilege that you can't find much elsewhere. And I'd like the honor to do it all over again. As vice chairperson, I would help lead this organization with passion, integrity, and humility. I would make decisions based on what is beneficial to all rather than what is beneficial to me or my fellow officers. I believe I have the resolve, ambition, and commitment to do well in this position. I would be accessible to any member of this community who needs me, listening to their concerns with an open mind and willpower to make change where change is warranted. With the power I would hold as vice chairperson, I hope to inspire others as past leaders in Sanjuan have inspired me. And with that, I thank you for your time, and I hope you can place your trust in me to be the next vice chairperson of Andres Bonifacio Sanjuan.